I'm here in Neston. Let me show you a great place to walk or run and some other sights along the way. Morning, so I parked here at the bottom of Denhall Lane at Ness, heading out. There's space here to park. A few cars. I'll show you some other places to park along the way. The fog is just starting to lift now, so I'm gonna head out. And we're off. So today we're in Neston. That's on the most westerly fringe of Cheshire, next to the Dee estuary. It's a beautiful spot. If you're an existing subscriber, welcome back. Hope you really enjoy this. For those of you who are new, welcome. There are new videos every week. Please consider clicking the subscribe button and then you'll get notified and you won't miss out. The details of this route are available on the website. See the details in the description. Today's route is a 9-mile route that takes us down the side of the Dee estuary, down past Neston to Parkgate, and then picks up the Wirral Way, which brings us back and back to our starting point. Along the way, we'll take in some of the sights. There's old quays, the colliery, the front at Parkgate, which is lovely. And then we'll head on down the Wirral Way, which is an old disused railway line. It really is a stunning route. Here we've got the site of Neston Colliery, a coal mine here from the beginning of the 18th century up until the 1920s, when it was decided it wasn't big enough to compete and was shut down. Here we've got the Harp Inn. Great spot to come and watch the sun go down. They've got benches outside and the sun goes down at night right there. Fantastic spot. This area's got a special meaning for me. I'm a Donnelly, and my family were economic migrants who came to England at the time of the potato famine, and so back then this is where the port was. They got off the boat and they liked it so much they stayed, and there are generations of my family buried in the church at Neston. Here's another place you could come and park. At Quayside, where, well, just over a mile into the route from where I started from. Nice. Just behind us, locals correct me if I'm wrong, behind us is what they locally call the lollipop. My dad tells tales of, as kids, they used to come and swim at the lollipop. There's a lollipop shaped bit which is deep water where they go swimming. Thank you. behind me, we've got the original water source for the area. There's a spring. See, it's flowing freely still. We've reached Parkgate. It's a lovely spot, Parkgate. Worth coming and just parking here just to walk along the front and have an ice cream from Nichols. Anyway, a little bit of history. So, as you can see, it looks like a harbour. There's a harbour wall. But where's the water? Well, this is the Dee estuary, and in time gone by there was water here up to the... I think actually the wall's quite modern, but there was water here and this was a port. So, going back to Roman times, as I might have mentioned in the Chester video the other week, the river, the estuary, went right into Chester, and where the race course is now. They would come all the way down here, past Shotton and in, and then the port was at Chester. But the estuary silted up. By about the 4th century, it was, you know, silted up at Chester. And so then the port moved to Burton, a little bit further down, and Neston. And then as that began to silt up again, the port moved to here, at Parkgate, where it stayed until about the 1860s, where it started to silt up here. You know, the boats would come in on a channel and then come off by rowing boat, I assume. Parkgate was a popular place for traders to live, you know, and so there's some nice houses down here. So after the 1860s, it became a place for people to come to the beach, but now, as you can see, people just still come for the ice cream, but the beach itself is not here anymore. You don't have to carry on very much further though. If you go to Thurston, a few miles down, or down past Colby to West Kirby, you know that the sand is still there. Famous people. Should we talk about famous people? because this was a port, so, you know, people have come through here. So one of the stories people tell is of Frederick Handel, and they say he went out and, you know, because the boat from here would go to Ireland, so there's talk that he went and then performed Handel's Mass, what have you. But I believe that that's not actually true, but he did actually pass through here. He came back this way from Ireland. The other famous person, we started down at Ness, and famous person from Ness is Emma, Lady Hamilton, Horatio Nelson's mistress. She's from Ness and, you know, would have been here at Parkgate. Anyway, I better crack on. Still more running to do. park, the old Baths car park, which is situated behind the boathouse at Parkgate. It's free parking. Again, I think there might be time restrictions on this for dawn to dusk type things, so which is why I didn't park here today. Thank you.
We could park here at Ropewalk Car Park on the Wirral Way at Parkgate, but again, it has a barrier that says close at 5, so no good if you're coming early or late.
The end now, we're just coming up on Ness Cafe. You might like to finish your walk there. Very popular with walkers and cyclists, snacks, drinks, and there's toilets there as well. It's just a little way just down here back to where we parked, so an ideal place to end your walk. Anyway, I hope you really enjoyed that. It's an absolutely stunning spot. I would highly recommend it. Next week we're heading to Little Lee and Acton Bridge. We're going to do another section of the Weave Away, also taking in the canal. Again, it's a beautiful spot. So anyway, take care. I'll see you next time.